someone. Yeah. Hello? Bubbers?
So this is Butts Park. Butts Park was called this because they actually butted up sand up against the walls here for testing. So it's actually a range testing area. So these blast walls, they do go sort of like 40 to 50 foot long, and there's another blast wall further down.
Yeah.
And then just behind there's a piece of canal there with an end on it where they used to bring all the ammunition in by barges.
Right. So
this was a testing area.
There's a massive wall, isn't it? Yeah, look at that.
I'm assuming, is that all the holes in the wall, or is that later?
It could be later, and all there's bullet holes and all sorts in there, there's all sorts of marks on the wall.
And you say that hole there, straight ahead, was put in the 80s?
In the 80s, yeah, when they built this and they put it through the park, they put it in the 80s.
Christ.
Look at the damage.
Oh, blind. Yeah. Looks like bullet holes. Right, so what's the next location?
Okay. This is such a big site, so much history. It goes back to what, 17th century?
Yeah, it's the 15th century and the Napoleonic times, all this was the Royal Arsenal.
Right. So there's a lot of history here, folks.
That's the side of the blast wall. So the barges would come up this canal with the ammunition on.
The ammunition on, yeah.
For using.
Yeah. For testing all the ammunition and stuff on these ranges.
Right. So, that's crazy.
Nowadays it's used for sort of like getting excess water out of the estate, like, you know, because it's on a sort of a floodplain.
Yeah.
But it's also natural beauty as well. We've got fish in there. But yeah.
Amazing.
But that's what it was meant eventually, you know, it was used for movement of ammunition. I've got a couple of photos of TE Beach. We're in here and they were putting the concrete bottom in.
Right.
Making it safe because it's sort of like, you know, it's quite deep. So they're making it safe. It's only about 3 foot high now. So, and they were actually putting the concrete edging on here. But originally there was all wooden barge boards and it was,
okay.
And there was cranes here as well. So I've got some old photos of the area.
Amazing.
Because these trains were so heavy, full of ammunition and bombs, they had to put these big concrete plinths in underneath the bridges. So this is the only original bridge left. All the rest were demolished or taken away or replaced by new lighter ones.
Right.
A lot of local people say, well, why is that bridge so massive? And this is an original railway bridge.
Taken away.
Yeah. There's lots of big spiders down there.
So how many miles of track was there again?
130 miles of railway track. And there was about 60 or 70 locos, as far as I know.
Right.
There's one left at Crossness now, called the Woolwich. That's the only one remaining left.
And they still use that, don't they? For,
yeah. It's not running at the moment, they're restoring it at the minute.
Oh, right.
But yeah, there's a lot of the railway lines and all that were taken from the Burma Railway and brought over and reused again on the Arsenal.
So back in the days, this is where the train would have gone through here?
That's right, yeah.
And what was it? They were experiment with ammunition.
Yeah,
in these,
this was actually a storage facility. This was right. Magazine 53.
Right.
So there would have been a big brick building in the middle.
Right.
And then the bank ran the outside to deflect any blast upwards, save hitting the rest of the buildings on the old Arsenal.
Yeah. It's pretty crazy. It's all overgrown now, though. I suppose back in the days, no trees at all.
No.
Totally exposed.
Check these jets out.
The magazine would have been here, so it would have been a big square brick building. I've got no photos of the building, because obviously photographs weren't allowed back then. Ever since now it's a nature reserve.
When did they demolish them?
Most of the buildings demolished in the 50s, 60s, and there was still some left in the 80s and 90s that were still demolishing. So even when I started here, there was quite a few buildings still left.
Yeah.
Are they bullet holes?
Like a cannonball or maybe bullets.
What's that? Is that some kind of reinforcing? Metal? Going through there.
So the flagpole with the red flag on it would have been on the brackets there, folks.
Besides,
look at the side of it. But what about this here? The impact marks. What's this here, Chris?
Oh, it could be, couldn't it?
Impact from the other side, where those, yeah. It is where those holes are.
It's blown the concrete out this way, same as that piece as well. So that impact there is, it's like a bullet wound, isn't it? Small at the front, big at the back. So that hole we looked at around the other side is opposite to this.
Christ.
So that's actually blown that brick block out about a good inch. But you think they were testing, so they didn't know the power of half of these things they was testing.
But if you look down it, it does stick out part of it.
Yeah, bulges at the bottom. Thames.
This part here, got the River Thames, looking nice. And you've got Dagenham Market opposite, so Dagenham in Kent, so you've got the market and that over there. So these stones here were all part of the arsenal. They were left here in the 80s as a feature. But what they used to do is they used to come up here with the train, so the train used to come up through the middle of these stones. And they would bring the trains up through here and they would lift all the gun barrels, freshly made gun barrels, onto these stones. Then they'd put double the amount of charge inside each barrel with a wire. And they had a big cable reel here with the wires on, and the train would pull the cables right the way down the other end, about 200 metres. They would blow it all up, then come back up, and whatever's left was usable. Whatever wasn't was smelted back down and remade into new cannons again. As we go around, you'll see there's dips in the concrete,
right,
where they test. Also, as well, they'd lean barrels against these and fire mortars into the end to land into the river. So just here, you've got the dip on this one, dip on this one. And then you've got these little bits here, which would, I don't know where they put the wiring through or something like that, something to hold the cannon in place.
Christ.
For holding this one as well. Or maybe there was to move the stones if they blew out of place.
Yeah.
Maybe it's that.
Big round hole there.
And also they would have got another one, a mortar cannon, put it up that way, in between here, fired it over into the river.
Right.
So they would testing and developing all sorts of weapons back then. And you'll just hear a very prominent dip on this one.
So the dates here, we're talking 1800s, late 1700s?
Yeah, it'd definitely be cannon barrels.
Yeah.
Yeah. As I say, it's not long enough for any up-to-date barrels like 105 or anything like that.
No.
It'd be all really old stuff. So the 18 gauge railway, it would have come straight down here. There may have been a crane on top of these, I'm not sure. It looks like there could have been some sort of crane or machine on top of that. And then they would have lifted them off. Maybe steam. They'd have to have some sort of lifting mechanism here, look. Yeah, so this is where they first tested the Maxim and the Vickers machine guns.
Right.
So they'd have three volunteers of an evening that worked on the Royal Arsenal. They weren't actually serving soldiers. Members of the public would volunteer to stay here. And they'd be like plotting up where the mines were being put in the Thames, because obviously this is the way into London. And so what they'd do is they'd wait for the morning and they would fire the machine gun and hit the mines.
Yeah, that's crazy. So, they were plotting them as they were, as the Germans were actually laying them.
It's a bit wet.
How many bits of blown up mine are out there?
Yeah.
It's a bit wet though, it's quite deep.
Oh, is it? Oh, yeah.
It's still wet. How you doing, mate? You all right?
Chris?
So that was for the cooker?
Yeah, so just inside there's a little cooking area. just inside the bunker. The bunker comes round like this and then goes into the main gun area there.
Right. It's
still part of the shelving there inside.
That's crazy.
Where they had the gun. And then this was a little cooking area at the side, like a little fireplace.
Yeah. Right there.
Maybe we can walk down the other side, maybe, I don't know.
We'll have a look. But yeah, there's a lot of graffiti in there though, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Looks like they have tried to seal it off at one point with the grate in there, but damn. But yeah, so the machine gun nest then, that's amazing. Amazing to see, folks. Amazing to see.
The wheels still work.
Yeah.
So that would doors for the magazine.
And that would
roller
doors
door,
for this
roller.
You know, so
you can shut it really quickly.
Amazing.
And would there have been a bigger gun on that? Not just a machine gun.
Like some sort of rangefinder or something, maybe? Or light anti-aircraft?
It could be, because the Luftwaffe did come down this river. They followed the river down.
Yeah, they did, yeah.
Across Nest's chimney.
Yeah.
So we're traveling along the river, more towards London now. And since the Napoleonic times, there's been boats and that coming up the river and getting their ammunition and stuff like that from the arsenal. So here we can see, only at low tide you can see this, which is all the docks and the bays where the boats used to come up and moor up on there to get their ammunition. So there's one this side and there's one further down.
So this is the First World War.
Yeah. So this one's the First World War. It's still got what they call like a, they used to use it on tanks, like a Zimmerit. So it's like a tar, black tar with stones in it, which anything hit it,
yeah,
then it would protect. Where you're standing right on that dangerous edge bit, was the World War II bunker was here. You can still see the bit of it over there.
Oh yeah.
It's a big, massive bunker. Literally fell straight into the river one day. I come down here and it was on its side and then it vanished into the river.
Christ.
You can see where this old bunker was.
It's a big old thing to disappear, isn't it?
Just disappear, yeah. Yeah. Like the war.
And it wasn't built like the other one further up. It wasn't concrete, it was brick built.
Oh, okay.
So that could have crumbled.
Yeah. As you can see, there's bits of it over there where that metal pole is sticking out.
Fence or... Yeah,
it
looks like it.
Yeah. Oh,
pole.
Yeah.
Look.
Proper erosion. Whoa! So that's the only remains of the
Oh no.
Yeah, the remains of the Second World War bunker.
Whoa!
Crazy, isn't it?
There's nothing underneath it.
No?
There's a big hole here.
It's the old water washing it, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's crazy, this tar stuff.
No, I didn't know what that was.
No. So it's basically resistant, blast yeah. resistant material. Very weird shape.
It's a shame how much of this has fallen off, isn't probably quite safe on the rocks. That is crazy that the World War One structure. Chris is there, look, he's trying to hide.
Show something.
Anyone
in there?
Oh, he's in there. Wow, he can get inside it, amazing. Well, sorry Chris, let's go. It's taking off.
Look how protected this piece is. It's still got the metal.
Oh look, yeah,
the corrugated. Noise, yeah, which obviously went over that. I held it all in, and that's what hence the shape.
Very small in level one.
Some bolts.
Yeah. I think you were saying about where the railing was.
They've taken it off.
You can still see.
What was that for?
Railing.
Oh, railings, all right.
There's a walkway around the outside of this. Like an observation walkway with railings around it with rope on it.
Yeah.
Looks like it's been taken off for safety reasons. This is a very small bunker inside. It's one of the strongest ones.
Got World War II, a World War I style tank.
God! That's like a foot thick.
Jesus.
Oh, look at the room.
Is there room enough for him, is it?
It's a boy, yeah.
What was that for?
Got shelving. Oh, shelving. Sorry.
Yeah, these are the ones I've got mixed up with the other one. This is the one still had the shelving brackets. This would be the lean with the rifles.
Okay. Yep.
So this would probably be rifle fire from this one.
Right. Amazing. Amazing view. I think I've seen World War One.
I'm especially this is kind of a bit worrying me now because we could roll down into the river in this.
Upside down.
I think, to be fair, if this falls over, it'll go one piece.
Yeah, it's just rolling.
I can't see this falling
like a car rolling.
No.
But yeah, there's a gap underneath that where the sea's actually, well, the river, folks, has eroded it a bit. Mm. Look, someone's trying to set a fire here, look.
Be nice to clear it out.
Yeah, clear it out, put a little gate on it, and then that's it, it's preserved. It looks like this has been burnt out and all that jazz, sadly.
Is that a remainder of a bench or something, maybe?
Yeah, would have been a little kick bench there. They'll be sitting down. There's them waiting, I suppose, with their helmets on.
Yeah.
And then there's a bit of trouble come. It was up onto the stick. Probably bullets on there as well.
Lee Enfield rifles?
Yep. And they've got a good view as well.
Well, those jets going past is amazing.
Jets in, people mine, it's not his fault.
Cool.
So I like these little stairs.
Yeah.
I think they're amazing.
See the way the bolts go all the way through? That's what held the stuff on the other side. And
The tin. Pushing it against
that's
it,
right through.
Push it that material, the blast.
Then I assume they mix the pebbles and that stuff up, pull it in the gap remaining.
Yeah. What's that material again, Chris?
It's called on tanks, they used it as Zimmerit. I don't know if this is exactly the same stuff, but it's like a Zimmerit, but it's more tar and stones.
Yeah.
Like a black tar.
So it's a blast protection, like blast absorption or something like that.
Yeah,
is that
the word? Anything that hit this bunker, yeah.
Yeah, that's amazing.
So it's about up to sort of naval standards as well, this.
Yeah. Crazy. Right.
Look at that. Very close.
And there's the little tiny steps.
It's amazing. They actually do look like they're slanting. Mm-hmm. They slant downwards on the thing.
Amazingly compact.
World War One bunker.
That's amazing. Right, so yeah, that's amazing to see that World War One bunker on the River Thames. Amazing stuff. Oh,